And you got a book, History of the Black Dollar.
Yes.
Okay, why do you think black people historically haven't been able to make their dollar work for them?
Well, the main part of it is group economics. Like, when I was younger, I'm from Cayman Park, the first black neighborhood in the country. And my great-grandmother always made us shop in D.C. as well as with black people. Mm-hmm. Like, she was adamant about it. We would have to drive around for miles just to find this specific person sometimes. And I never understood it until mm-hmm. I wrote the book. And so a part of my research, it would take us over 250 years to be able to catch up with our counterparts if we do not exercise group economics. Mm. And so it's essential. That's the only way that we're going to be able to close this wealth gap. We have to be able to put our money where our mouth is and actually collectively share with each other.
Mm-hmm. Good morning. I hope everyone is getting a balanced breakfast today to energize themselves. Studies have shown that without proper nutrients, learners perform less on assessments and their ability to learn. There is a direct relationship between hunger and low academic performance. Anyways, today we're going to dive further into our understanding of quadratic equations with a slight focus on business and entrepreneurialism. By the end of the day, students will be able to build a profit or area equation in intercept form. The essential questions for the day are, what steps must we take to calculate the quantity function? How do we calculate revenue? Why does the revenue start to drop after a certain point? These will be our discussion questions that are going to be featured on Google Classroom, in which you can earn extra credit by making scholarly responses, and by extending the conversation to your peers, you can earn additional extra credit points. I see this as an absolute win, all today in Escobar's class. We are going to start to build a revenue function based on what we know about quadratic functions. This is a particularly interesting lesson for me because one of the goals that I have is actually starting a business in Bolivia where I'll be creating Andean-based clothes and then selling them here in the United States. This is a very important lesson because it's the beginning stages if you ever want to sell a product or create a business. With that being said, I want you to think of a product that you would like to sell or a business you would like to start. So when starting a business, you need to find a way to make money off of it. Here are some essential questions. What are some of the operating costs or the startup costs? So for my example, for Andean Clothes, the startup cost would be materials, pay my employees, the rent of the building of which they work in, and the website and travel and shipment. Because it's coming from a different country. So we have to go through customs there. This all leads up to our revenue. Now what revenue is the total amount of income that generates by the sale of goods and services. It is the amount of products that you're selling multiplied by the price per each item. It can be also written as R of X equals Q of X times the amount of dollars per item. This is what's going to lead into the importance of understanding what profit is. Profit is the amount of income that remains after paying all of the operating costs. Therefore, the equation profit equals revenue minus operating costs, or more algebraically, P of X equals R of X minus operating costs, dollar symbol. It is important to know that the revenue function is a quadratic function, so watch out for that x squared term. And for our profit function, we're going to be dealing with a linear function in the form of slope-intercept form, y equals mx plus b. Now looking at our equation for profit, how can we utilize the revenue and or operating costs to increase our profits? Lastly, what is the difference between revenue and profit? You'll be seeing these questions in our discussion board on Google Classroom. Now, a quick commercial from one of our unofficial sponsors.
Yeah, I mean, how special is this that you get to share your mom and your family history with the rest of the country?
It's just fantastic. We just love that everybody loves this story. You know, it's the story that we love, and we're able to carry on our family's legacy, and people love the story. They come in for more than just pie.
Yeah.
They feel like they're coming into, you know, a family that, you know, just love each other, and we do.
Yeah.
So we have a really good time, and so do the customers. Yeah.
All right.
Example one. A stadium has found that if ticket prices are $10, then 10 people will come to the game. However, if the 10 tickets cost $5, then 8,000 people will come. Assuming the relationship is linear, find the quantity function, Q of X, where Q represents the number or quantity of tickets sold, and X represents the price per each ticket. You should note that you have an independent X variable, which is the price per ticket, and a dependent Y variable, which is the quantity of people who are buying these tickets. When we're annotating, X equals 10, Y equals 3,000, X equals 5, Y equals 8,000, and we're trying to find the quantity function. Now that we establish our mathematical annotations, we can now create 2 points. Good. Now that we have our 2 points, please calculate slope of these 2 points. Now that we have calculated slope to be negative 1,000, we have to create it into a fraction to give it some additional context in regards to the word problem. What that means is, for every $1 increase in price, the number of tickets sold will decrease by 8,000 people. Please have this in your notes. Now that we have solved for slope with the given 2 points, we have an option to use either the point slope form or slope intercept form. We're going to go over using the slope intercept form. However, because we've done this in class, for extra credit, if you would like to go through the procedure of how to solve for the function using the point slope form, we can get extra credit for it. But now that we're choosing the slope intercept form, we again have 2 options. We're going to be using the 0.10, 3,000. Because the Y values is much smaller, so overall we're going to be using smaller values. However, for another extra credit opportunity, solve for B using the points 5, 8,000. We remain our results as 3,000. Negative 1,000 times 10 is negative 10,000 plus B. We then add, to get to the other side of the equation, we add 10,000 to each side. Therefore, B equals 3,000 plus 10,000, 13,000. Now that we solve for our B value, we can also write it as the point 0, 13,000. Now, and another way to solve for this, you could have just noticed that the difference of our x values goes down by 5. So 10 minus 5 is 5, 5 minus 5 is 0. And when that happens, what happens to our y values? They both increase by 5,000. And so 8,000 plus 5,000, 13,000. Now that we know our slope and our y-intercept, we can finalize our function of the slope in the slope intercept form. So y is going to be our q of x, our quantity function, which is what we were looking for all along. Our slope, negative 1,000, with the x variable, plus 13,000. This is how much our initial cost will be. Utilizing our linear function, using the slope-intercept form, we have q of x equals negative 1,000x plus 13,000. Therefore, the quantity function determines how many people will come to the game
if we charge them a certain X price.
You now have enough information to answer part A for both questions in problem set A and problem set B. Now let's move on so we can solve for the revenue function of the given scenario.
Example 1, part B. Again, assuming the relationship is linear, find the revenue function R of X, where R represents the revenue earned and X represents the price of each ticket. Now going back to our equation of revenue, R of X equals Q of X times the dollars of price tickets per item, we can now substitute for the values of which we know. Therefore, we have our revenue function, R of X, equals that quantity function we just solved for, negative 1,000x plus 13,000, multiplied by the amount of cost per each ticket, which we do not know, so we leave it as x. Now, we can distribute this x value, which simplifies the equation, in which we get negative 1,000x squared plus 13,000x. This is our quadratic equation for a revenue function. Now with every quadratic function, we can create a graph. This parabola is described by the revenue, by the number of people, in which we can identify two x-intercepts and a vertex or maximum, meaning that there is a max price that can be charged before the revenue starts to decrease.
If you learn how to play the economic game, you can use that as effectively as any other tool of war, right? Black people had $1 trillion spending money, and we spend it in an unfocused way, so our dollar and we are not respected. So amidst all this turbulence in America right now, my solution for how to improve our communities is to start to economically insulate ourselves from oppression by banking black, buying black, being black, and letting everything else take care of itself.
He has created a website that promotes only black businesses. He makes sure each potential seller is indeed African American. It's a non-negotiable condition to be allowed to trade on this online platform. Everything is for sale on WeBuyBlack.com, even a laundry detergent made, packed, and sold by a black-owned company.
Now, class, you have enough information to answer the problems in problem set A, B, and the exit ticket. Make sure you submit your work by 4 p.m. at the latest. You can also come to our office hours in which we will be going over the star problems of these questions as well as getting some discussion about the concepts you've been hearing about in this video. While you're submitting your work, I'll be waiting on my beanie bag, reading a book, and drinking some nice coffee. Until next time in Escobar's class.